Okay. Now let's... Are we going to get it? Is it going to be good? Is this going to loop back around and give me the intro? I can't remember if it does. That's kind of what I'm hoping for it to do. It is!
Yes! I am a streaming genius.
How's that?
We've got to have the beautiful intro. Admittedly, you know, with the sidebar and everything. But the beautiful intro to Pokemon Storm Silver. Liberate the 52nd is first. Oh, there he is. Ethan. And Lyra, I think is her name.
I can't tell you.
Oh, there he is. There's our rival. Silver. Or so you think that's what he's going to be called.
Okay. Oh my God, is that an old Chissy and James?
Oh, the absolute relics. I forget their names. I know the like the main rocket guy you face is Archer. Well, in the base Pokemon Soul Silver, because we're not dealing with our average Pokemon game anymore.
Oh, yeah, no, we're not.
This! No information is needed. I am a Pokemon master. This! Hopefully I'll actually, you know, get to the text that I'm after. Uh-huh. Welcome to Sacred Gold or Storm Silver, the Draiano hack. So, spoilers. I've talked about doing this as a Nuzlocke for a long time, but I was going to hold out because I know he's working on, like, a redux of them. Because, you know, he released these back in, like, 2012, I want to say. And Draiano has been working on a redux of them. However, I recently discovered that the redux of Sacred Gold and Storm Silver has now been changed to Pokemon Aurora Crystal, and it is a long way from completion. At which point, I basically told myself I didn't want to wait any longer, and I wanted to play them. That, and I was inspired by Pokemon Challenges to play them. Yes, I am indeed a boy. I did check my genitalia.
You did it earlier in the toilet.
Can verify. These guys heard and verified. We shall go. I feel like I've really used Enigma recently. I've been Simon. Let's go with the classic. Enigma. Yes, there we are. Splendid. Joining me today is the beautiful Michael.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, mate. Awful.
How's it going, Governor?
It's going well.
Is that your Bayou voice, yeah?
Apparently so.
Okay, yep, yeah, I can't wait to turn this tech speed up to fast. Oh my god. Literally the thing I despise the most about the intro to Pokemon games. Right. Oh, can I not use the menu yet? Fiddlesticks.
You've not unlocked the menu yet.
Okay, yep, I actually haven't. Oh, Lyra, yep. What would I like to do with Lyra's... I can't delete it! Damn it!
Avenger, excited.
I want to delete the mail.
She could have just sent that as a text message.
She could have done. Ah, no, emails were the thing back when... Not when this game released, you know, the Heart Gold and Soul Silver. But they were the thing when...
Phones were the size of bricks then.
Yeah, when Gold and Silver released, that was around the time, you know, they made a big deal at the start of the game about emails. So, you know, emails are like the in thing then. And we got the bicycle and the running shoes. Heck yes. And, oh, the Game Boy. I forgot we get the Game Boy sounds at the start. So we can actually have it sound like a Game Boy game. Right. Yep. Love you, mother.
Ooh,
you're the bestest. That's me pressing the Y button. That's the bag. Trying to remember what I've mapped all my commands to on my Nintendo DS. Right, fast text. Battle scene on. Battle style. This is going to always make the Nuzlocke the hardest for me, because I've always played Shift, and I want to improve my ability as a Nuzlocker, and I feel the best thing and the best way that I can start doing that without making it too hard off the bat, because, you know, I have thrown myself into the deep end at times, I'm just going to put it to set. I think set is a marvellous. Frame. What frame do we want? That frame 7 is quite delightful. That's very Team Rocket. I don't want that. Wow, there are many frames. More frames than I dared to imagine. Frame 7, it's purple. And purple is best colour. Okay. Could register the bike. I am, however, just going to do... There we go. Lovely. Enable the running shoes.
Right, I return.
That was Mother Dearest, I assume, yes?
No, that was my order of the curry.
Ah, I see. What colour did you go for, good sir?
My usual. Chicken madras with pillau rice and naan bread with some pompadoms.
Nice, nice. What naan?
However you wish to pronounce it.
Just a plain naan?
Just plain naan. But that's usually because every time I get to the menu, I cannot remember which one is which.
I mean, you could just Google it.
That's effort.
I mean, it's
not... And
I'm
hungry. When I'm hungry, no effort happens.
Yeah, but plain naan is... I mean, don't get me wrong, there's nothing wrong with a plain naan, but you could have some, like, variety. Variety is the spice of life, sir.
All right, Mr. Smarty Pants. What's a peshwari naan?
Isn't that the coconut one?
It's just coconut, yeah.
Yes!
What's with the yes?
And the backup was the fact that I got it right. Our second guest of the stream have arrived. It is Mr. Ellis.
Mm-hmm. Just got back from my hybrid curry, so...
Yeah, Curry McKenzie over here, and you might ask yourselves, chat, what did I have? What curry did I eat? I didn't, actually. I haven't even had dinner yet. yes, is this where I get to pick my Pokemon? Splendid. Okay. Now, I do wonder what Pokemon I'm going to go for. Am I going to go for no one's favourite starter, Chikorita? Gotcha. The grass type Pokemon. Because Chikorita...
I think we know what's going to happen.
This is a Nuzlocke. We could go for Chikorita, a synthesis. That's great in a Nuzlocke. We could go for Totodile, the water Pokemon. Hey, you know, decent attack. Water Pokemon are always useful to have. And this thing gets ice coverage and it could help me with dragons. Or am I going to go for my favorite Pokemon? Oh, gee. I wonder. Gimme.
This is where it gets Cyndaquil, and it's got the worst stats ever.
give me a Cyndaquil.
Hand me the Cyndaquil. Yes, we need a nickname. Right, we have the male nature. It's not like the one for the Nuzlocke for the boys that had the 12% female nature. Okay, we need a nickname for this Cyndaquil, which is eventually going to become a Typhlosion. Bear that in mind. Gary.
No, not Gary.
All right, what's your pitch? You can't immediately shoot down Gary and then come up with nothing. Like,
I'm trying to think.
I know. I erased Gary. Francois.
Oh, of course. How could I get? How could I forget? Yes.
I was going to say Blaze.
That's his ability.
Yeah.
Francois. The legend that is Francois, yes! Sacre bleu!
Francois once started out as a battle bot in our Robot Wars play.
It did that, and then it became the Stormtrooper in Battlefront 2.
Then it became pretty much everyone in our pit, in your PlayStation 2 save files.
What is the name of your enemy in this one?
I get to name them.
Oh!
Stanley.
Okay, we've got a low HP roll. It is an impish nature. I want to say that's neutral. I was wrong. It's defense up, special attack down.
Lol. I told you it's going to get a bad roll.
That's literally
the worst roll you could probably have got.
Yeah. Yeah, that's so bad. Also, it has flash fire, not blaze. That's good at least. We'll take that. Okay, that's fine. Hey, listen. Francois is here on the team. We appreciate Francois. Okay, so this is a perfect opportunity for me to explain the rules of the Nuzlocke for those of you that maybe do not understand what a Nuzlocke is. I know this is going to be of Kirsty's benefit because...
Yeah, I don't know what that is.
Yeah, she has no idea. Okay.
I was about to say Kirsty.
So, of course, we have Pokemon where, you know, the aim of the game is to catch them all, right? That's what you do. You fill up the Pokedex.
Yeah, I got that one.
That's not how a Nuzlocke works.
Okay.
So the way a Nuzlocke works, it's an imposed set of rules and challenges to basically make the game harder. So, we have our starter Pokemon. And then eventually we will gain access to use Pokeballs. What that then means, after we obtain Pokeballs, we are only allowed to catch the first Pokemon we encounter on each route. Should you kill it, that route is dead. You can't catch another Pokemon there.
Okay.
So we have a limited number of Pokemon. If a Pokemon faints in your possession, it is considered dead. You can release it, or what I prefer to do is I put them in the, what a lot of people prefer to do is put them in a dead box in the PC so you can, you know, memorialize your fallen warriors, and I tend to play bagpipe music whenever they die. We also nickname our Pokemon because that forms a stronger bond with your Pokemon.
Does it actually?
I don't know. I never used to nickname my Pokemon. Now I can't imagine not nicknaming my Pokemon because it's fun. An imposed rule that I've put on myself on this one to make it that much harder is I've always played Pokemon with the shift battle style, which is when you know what your opponent's sending in. I've put that to set, so I won't know what my opponent is sending in. So it means I basically don't get to switch for free. I will be using items in battle because I don't want to make this too hard for me, but I'm going to try and limit it in some capacity because I don't basically want to break out a super soaker every time I'm in a pinch. I'm going to allow gift Pokemon not to count as, like, encounters. So, like, if there is a random route, let's say, where I can get a gift Pokemon, I'm also allowed to do my one catch on that route just because I think that makes the games more fun, especially these quality of life hacks such as this one. And that should pretty much cover it, I think.
Where do you keep these rules to remember them? Are they built into the game, or do you just have them off to the side somewhere?
I know them. I know them. Mans has been Nuzlocking for over 10 years. You know, I know what I'm doing.
I'm not going to lie. It sounds like the name of a Pokemon anyway.
It is, because there is a Pokemon called Nuzleaf.
Well, there you go.
And Nuzleaf, Nuzlocke started off as a webcomic. And I think at the time, the person playing it was like, oh, what if, like, when my Pokemon fainted, they died? And I don't think they had a name for it, but I'm fairly certain, I could be misremembering this, but I'm fairly certain the first Pokemon to faint was called Nuzleaf, or the Nuzleaf was the first Pokemon to faint. And from that point forward, it was called the Nuzlocke Challenge. Anyway, sure, I remember how to use it. Okay, so...
A bit of general trivia there.
I love me some general trivia. So right now, we don't have Pokeballs. So the challenge is not in effect yet. We get Pokeballs once we come back to this town, because right now we have to go to Mr. Pokemon's house, get the egg, and we'll conveniently meet Professor Oak and get our Pokedex. And then once we've done that, we then have to battle our rival. We come back here, get the Pokeballs, and then we can start catching Pokemon. And ideally...
standing in the window.
It's funny you should say that. That is our rival character. Notice how they are not just generic NPC. It's not Team Rocket, but for those of you that don't know your Pokemon, that is Silver, otherwise known as Giovanni's son. Giovanni being the leader of Team Rocket. There's some more trivia for you.
Oh, the one with the Persian.
There you go, yeah.
I remember that from the cartoon anime.
Oh, look at Sentret. Ain't it cute? Francois! Into battle, my beast. Let's see how Francois fares up. That's not a bad bit of damage, you know.
Good thing it's defense up.
Oh, and the crit. There you go. Look at that. 24 XP. Lovely. Francois, already halfway to leveling up.
Whoa, we're halfway there.
Wow. So, some of these routes are going to be critical. I get the feeling... I'm hoping to kind of get lucky because... the first gym in this game is a flying gym. And realistically, we're going to need something defensive and super effective against flying types to be able to take that out. Thankfully, we can catch a rock-type Pokemon hereby. But of course, with it being a Nuzlocke, it's about luck on the encounter.
So, if... Francois goes down now and air quote faints.
Uh-huh.
Does that mean your game has finished?
No, because I have not got Pokeballs yet.
Okay, so you have to have the Pokeballs.
Yes, I have not received a Pokeball as of yet. Fuck yeah, Francois. You learn that, Smokescreen boy.
Smokescreen?
Yeah, this is like a very lax set of Nuzlocke rules. I am playing an increased difficulty hack, though. Which has, like, some quality of life improvements. And there was something else that I was going to say, which has completely escaped me right now. Yeah, the fact that this thing has Dizzy Punch at level 3 is just sickening. That did 9?
Well. Oh my god.
I could run from these Pokemon if I wanted to, but right now we need the experience. We need to level up because we need to make sure we're like, better than our rival.
Survivable.
And the survivability. Do I have a berry? The Chilean berry. What the fuck, bro?
That little shit.
Yeah, you know what? I'm out of here. I don't want to battle you, Retara. I don't want to waste these potions. You know, I get given potions early on. I want to keep them.
Seriously, what is it? Every 3 seconds or?
This is just. It's just an oddity, the fact that this is happening so frequently. It's not, like, set to anything, you know. And realistically as well, I'm pretty sure sprinting or running improves... not improves, but it, like, means Pokemon are more likely to appear. But, of course, you want
that... You're more aggressive, so you startle them more.
Yeah, you want that speed. You want that monka speed. You need to move.
It makes me laugh, because there'll be the times where all you want is Pokemon and you get nothing.
Oh, it happens.
Maybe when I play.
Nope.
Run.
Right, we're gonna come back. We're gonna come back for that Apricorn. Oh yeah, I don't have the Apricorn box anyway, so I can't even get that yet. Cherry Grove City. Hello, old man. Oh, Mike, you're in the game.
Oh, frown lines.
I think he's. Oh no, there he is.
Shoot an arrow through my heart.
We're gonna get educated on towns. If you didn't know, that's Pokemon Center.
Oh, he left.
Bye, Mike.
Pokemon.
You saddened him so much that he dipped.
Route 30's out that way. Oh, yeah, he's back. God, this man is on the move.
That dude
mainly because I'm
move.
Far too nice to mine good.
So the reason in the base game that this guy can move and that you can't is because he has running shoes. Obviously this is a quality of life hack, so we have running shoes, but that's the thing. So now he'll give us the old rod.
Mike?
I'm not dignifying that with response.
So we are going to heal our absolute Giga Chad, Francois, over here. How many potions have I got, actually? I want to say I got given 5 potions by the, Professor's aide.
Look at my boy.
I want to say that rings a bell.
Because I know he gives potions. I thought he gave...
3 or 5, then.
We have... 5 potions. Nice. Okay. Vovots, on to Route 30. We're probably going to be coming back a fair bit here. Ah. Good day, sir.
No.
He has forgotten to give me... Okay. Ah, yes, the map card. So we now have a town map. Splendid. Mm-hmm. Yep. Understood. Excellent.
Bye.
Goodbye, friend. All right, on to Route 30. Goodbye, my friend.
You got to start singing that every time you lose a Pokemon now.
Absolutely not. It's a Metapod. Does it only know Harden? Ask him for a friend. Because if it does, if it does, this could be great experience. Oh, yes.
Yeah, it's really nice.
Metapod used explode.
Okay, what? Right, yeah, let's... yeah, Metapod used explosion. Be like, no! This is level 7 right here.
What does a Metapod become?
Butterfree. Yeah. I love Butterfree. Butterfree is such a really good early game Pokemon as well, especially if it gets the Compound Eyes ability, which means it like has an increased chance to hit. Because then you have access to all the powder moves like Sleep Powder, Poison Powder, Stun Spore. He's a good Pokemon.
It's good, yeah.
Is Pokemon an anime or a cartoon?
It's a great question.
It's an anime.
So in the anime, he gave up Butterfree, didn't he?
Yeah, he let it go off with the pink Butterfree.
Did you cry?
Yes.
I did not.
I loved Ash's Butterfree, man.
When Ash's Butterfree went, do you know what I said to the TV screen? I whispered.
Good riddance.
No, I whispered to it, goodbye, you little shit. This was yesterday.
This was just this morning, as a matter of fact. Okay. So now we're going to chat to this dude.
I need something to watch on the train.
And we're going to grab the apricorn box. This is what I say on the stream title. This is mostly blind because I have played Storm Silver before. I'm going to keep it a buck 50. That was 10 years ago. And I replayed the start up to Violet City just to make sure it worked. So I know what I'm doing right now. However, that is soon going to change.
Hang on, was it a grunt?
It was a grunt apricorn, yes.
A grunt, yes.
Yo, Kakuna! Maybe this thing only knows Harden as well. Kakuna becomes Beedrill.
I should have known that one.
Kirsty's, she's got more knowledge than she thought.
It's been a real long time since I played Pokemon.
This thing does only know Harden. Could we get to level 8? When do we get Ember? Is it level 8 or level 9?
I want to say 9.
I also want to say 9. Oh, come on. You have teased me and proceeded to not please me. Take that antidote, though. Good day, friend. How are we? Sir. Ha! Pokemon doesn't have any PP left. Good old youngster Joey having a massive battle with the wild Pidgey. All right, what else we got in here? So we've seen Surskit. We've seen Kakuna. We've seen Metapod. What else is on Route 30? I want to say at night you can actually catch a Poliwhirl. Yo.
I've never seen that one before.
Hello.
Taillow and Swellow are fantastic Pokemon.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Ouch. How much I can do? Okay, we'll take 3. This will take us to level 8.
I mean, Francois has solid defense, so he should be tanking these hits.
Francois is a defensive bastion. Level 33. That's some speed EVs right there from the Taillow as well. Not quite got Ember yet, so yes, that is level 9. Oh, mother dearest. Step on me respectfully.
Is that meant to be a punk?
What? My name is indeed Enigma. Ah, Cynthia, utterly pleasure to meet you.
Also, I heard what you said earlier. I'm not doing that. It makes me uncomfortable.
Would you do it for a sizable amount of money? Anyway, she's basically rattling off some stuff about Sinnoh. But, yes, we have an Eevee. We have an Eevee. I think I know what I want this Eevee to be, but sadly, that's outside of my control somewhat. Okay, male Eevee, I need a name.
Barbell.
I'm named
Barbell. Barbell.
Yeah. But you put an E on the end of Bell and it makes it Bell.
I mean, yeah, but it's also a dude.
Oh, is it male one? Oh,
yeah.
Just no E then. Bubble.
Name of Biscuit.
All right, Ellis is throwing out Biscuit. I tell you what, let's go on a rotation. Mike got the Cyndaquil. Yep. Then Kirsty's gone for Barbell. Ellis, you've got the next mon, and then we go in a rotation.
Okay.
Get thinking,
boy. It's hard to think when I don't know what the Pokemon's going to be.
Exactly. I keep pressing the wrong button. Okay, so what nature did we get for Barbell? Okay. Oh, a hasty nature. That's defense down, speed up.
It's
He's going to be getting those hits in.
And it has adaptability. Adaptability is very good. Okay. Speed up, defense down. That would be very good for like a Jolteon or an Espeon. You know, something like that. I mean, I don't know what I'm going to evolve it into. I have an idea on what it could become, though. Because I've got to bear in mind, this is a Nuzlocke. This isn't just Simon playing Pokemon for the funsy doodles, you know.
Could it become the very best?
Like no one ever was.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're going to get ourselves a Pokemon computer? Egg.
If Eevee evolves, would it lose the adaptability or that style?
It will lose adaptability and it will change depending on what Pokemon it evolves into.
Gotcha.
If it were to go to my favourite evolution, which is Espeon, it will have Synchronize, I want to say. Which is when the Espeon is inflicted with the status condition, it will then inflict it upon the enemy. So if you paralyse the Espeon, it will then paralyse the Pokemon that paralysed it.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Good day, Professor Oak. How are we? The intro to this game is a lot of big talky talk. And I used to be one of those guys when I made Pokemon content that would read out the names and give the characters voices. Yeah, no. I'm not there anymore. Not that guy anymore.
You don't have to do it, but Mike.
I could if you paid me.
So Mike is like, no, I will not do voices. However, if I put my camera on, I shall communicate through interpretive dance.
No, but if you did pay me, I would do it.
We already saw Mike's interpretive dance over the weekend, you know. We can't have the Rizzler on stream,
no,
you know what I'm saying?
What we saw was just impeccable dancing.
That's what I mean.
Those lips, those hips did not lie.
I mean, his lips didn't either, if you know what I'm saying.
I didn't think I was that good.
Here's the thing.
He was up there with Catherine, and Catherine was bouncing all over the place.
Here's the thing. With dancing, 50% of it is just commitment. It's not even the moves that you're doing. It is just sending it.
The confidence to do it.
Yeah.
Yep.
No fair.
Oh, yes. We are going to get some solid XP for Barbell right here. Well, let's just speed this up a little bit. Oh. Absolute Chad energy. So we're going to do... just a tiny modicum of grinding. Just a tiny modicum of grinding. Because we're going to have the rival battle after Cherry Grove City.
Oh, it's a Caterpie!
And quite frankly, I want to do well in the rival battle. Get it out of the way. Obviously not lose any Pokemon. And of course, we've got like trainer battles and other shit coming up in the not too distant future. So we need to have two strong Pokemon to lead our team, that being our starter in this Eevee, Weedle. And then we've got to train up the Schmucks, you know? Don't get poisoned.
You know,
good.
I always thought it was odd that the trainers that you can't encounter, when you're playing the game normally, only have like one or two Pokemon. But now it's just occurred to me, they're Nuzlocking it.
Do you know what? That's an excellent point you bring up, Mike. They could also be Nuzlocking. So, yeah. Just a small modicum of grinding at this exact moment, because unfortunately, this game does go a little bit hard.
Sorry.
This is Quick Attack. Seedot might not be the worst encounter. I mean, to be fair, the move pool of, like, the Seedot, Nuzleaf, Shiftry line is... Oh, no. No, I can kill it. We're fine. So Bide is terrifying in the sense of it stops that Pokemon from moving, but any damage that is dealt to it is then dealt to the opponent. I have lost Pokemon because of Bide in Nuzlocke in the past. Oof. So, you know, just something to be aware of. Right, I want to get Barbell to level 8 and I want to get Francois to level 9, I think. Okay, so Francois is not going to be that hard. Barbell is requiring a bit more effort to level up, which is fine.
Well, you know, when doing those Barbell exercises.
This is true. Oh my goodness gracious me. We have the chance to get a Ralts. Bruh.
Hell yeah.
I could get the waifu Pokemon.
noticed.
Except for that one when I'm in a hobby.
That would have been Husbando. That's the thing. We do have some naming conventions around here as well. There are Pokemon that just have names.
Well, if you encounter those Pokemon and you do capture them, then you'll let us know immediately.
Exactly. Like a female Ralts or Curlia and Gardevoir is Waifu. Male Ralts, Curlia or Gallade is Husbando.
Husbando.
They're the ones that immediately come to mind. I think there are some others, but I'd need to review some old Pokemon footage. I don't have Ember yet. It's at level 10. Bro, that's fine.
Seems a bit odd.
We'll get it. I only really need to worry about it because of, like, the bug catchers and shit that are, like, coming up after we, you know, go through everything. Bug Bite is such a strong move to have early game. It's got 60 base power. Thankfully, the Pokemon using it are, you know...
garbage.
Dog shit. Oh.
Mr. Harden himself.
I'm not opposed to these defense EVs that I'm getting. Okay. Easy enough. Nice. And then once we get barbell to level 8, we will proceed in the direction known as forwards. Or rather down and forwards towards the actual, like, objective, you know? Get shit on, nerd. Wants to learn bite. Oh, absolutely. Probably never going to use Helping Hand, in all honesty. All right. Nice. Okay, so, rival fight. Back to New Bark Town, obtain Pokeballs, Nuzlocke challenge begins. I also need to play around with some of the settings on this and make it look a little bit nicer. I also can't wait to eat after stream. I'm already thinking about post-stream dinner.
What are you hankering for?
I will be breaking out some of those Jamaican patties I bought the other day.
Oh.
Only one, you know, a nice light dinner. Hello, rival. Mm-hmm, the Pokemon's too good. Well, it's a good thing you're not fighting Francois, you're facing Barbell. The Heart Gold Soul Silver rival has some of my favourite rival battle music. It is the metal remix is still my, like, subscriber / follower notification music to this day.
My daddy owns a corporation.
No! Get shit on, nerd. This Eevee just fucked his Totodile up. K. Die.
It just tore its throat out.
Adaptability goes hard. Nice. Didn't even get to listen to the rival theme for that long. Later, friend. Or not friend. I did see your name. We now know his name. And his name is John Cena!
Oh, God.
I showed my age a little bit there. Don't worry. No. This ROM hack shows its age very quickly. You'll know when you see it. I forgot about it, and it's when I was playing through the intro the other day. I was like, oh, it's this old, is it? We're investigating the case of the missing Pokemon. Man, who could it be? A red-haired boy. Oh, boy. It wasn't me. I was offered a Pokemon. Hands up. I was offered a Pokemon. We're fine. Oh, I did get his name. Oh, I got his name.
Tilly. Oh, isn't it Ellis' turn to choose one anyway?
Oh, Ellis is naming the Pokemon. This is the rival.
I was about to say, I was naming the Pokemon, yeah.
As is customary...
Dick, oh, yeah.
I mean, Dickwad is oh, of course, why don't we just call him oh. Fart? You know, like...
They call him Boner Fart.
I thought you was about to put in Chris, and I was going to say, wow.
No. I was going to call it Chat. That's like the customary rival name.
Yeah, call him Chat.
Okay. Let's stick to tradition, you know. Chat, you are my nemesis. Forever and always.
Only because Boner Fart doesn't fit.
Boner Fart wouldn't have fit. So Chat was his name. O-C-H-A-T-O. Doesn't quite work, does it? Goodbye, officer. Okay, bye. This is the one thing about Pokemon games, man. I've already said it. There is just so much talky, man. Yep. Understood. Someone, please give me the Pokemon balls. Oh, I will absolutely take the gym leader challenge. 100%.
Just give me the fucking balls.
Yeah, give me the balls so I can start this masochist run. Oh, okay.
Whoa.
I don't get them yet, actually. I just realized in this game you get them from Lyra. Because she gives you the Pokemon catching tutorial. Where's Good day, down mother. Down.
Mother, where is Lyra?
Do I want... yes.
Can I just speak with her?
She has.
So I learned the other day, right? That... Because I've always been against your mother saving money in this because, you know, you therefore get less after you win the Pokemon battles. However, your mother in this game will occasionally spend the money on rare items. Could work out into our favor. No, I'm saying, like, for real. Okay. So, we now get a catching tutorial because I don't know how to catch Pokemon. I've never played this game before.
Remind me again. Is it a case of that you can't buy any Pokeballs?
You can't buy Pokeballs right now. You are able to buy Pokeballs after the catching tutorial, which we're getting right now.
No, I mean in the Nuzlocke challenge.
No, you can buy Pokeballs.
Okay, it's just I remembered something. I think it was like a super hard version of it where you can't buy Pokeballs. You have to rely on one super.
I did see a super hard version someone did where he could only use the Pokemon Center in the towns once, and he was able to use it a second time if it had a gym and if he beat the gym. I was like, you, sir, are built differently. You are constructed in a different manner. Right. Sir, Francois is up first. How many Pokeballs do we have?
Five.
No, we're going to have more. 15 Pokeballs.
256.
All right, team. Nuzlocke starts now.
It's going to be a Rattata.
Let's go! It is a Pidgey. We officially have Burb. Well, we don't officially have Burb yet. We could have Burb. Okay. Francois, don't kill it. Good, Francois. Good. And now, initiate Pokeball. Hold down and B like I've always done. I know it doesn't do anything. It just makes me feel better.
It was one of those urban legends that went around.
There were a few. There was down and B. There was repeatedly tap A. All right, and that is the first Pokemon of the Nuzlocke obtained via capture. Pidgey.
Flying boy.
The male Pidgey. Alex, what you got for me?
Oh. Oh.
When you look at a pigeon... Or a Pidgey. What do you think, Alice?
I have a great one.
Unfortunately, you're going to have to save that for another.
It's not your turn.
No. Call it Harper.
Harper. Okay.
Yeah.
Like the group in the Forgotten Realms.
Mm.
Okay, Harper. Let's have a little butchers at Harper, shall we? Wonder, is there a way for me to actually heal Harper? Adamant nature, that's not dreadful. Attack up, special attack down. Tangled feet raises evasion if the Pokemon is confused. It ain't dreadful. It ain't dreadful. Okay. Right, we will now proceed in the direction known as forwards. could have had a Sentret, but we didn't. I do need to get Francois Ember. Ow. Okay, there we go. Unfortunately, the XP of these Pokemon is becoming pitiful.
Non-existent.
Oh, there's a cut. I never saw that cut through. Okay. Now we're going to go to Route 46. This is the important route. This is the one where I need some luck. Come on, big money, big money, big money. No whammies, no whammies. Big money, no whammies. I've just remembered another Pokemon that has a naming convention. And we didn't get it! Okay, that's not what I expected. Mike, start thinking.
Oh, look for this Jigglypuff.
So it's got Sing. That's not necessarily a bad thing.
I mean, you could always start off with it, drop the condition, get something asleep, and then batter it with another Pokemon.
The only problem is, Sing has 55 accuracy.
Yeah.
Ah, son of an alien whore. Or daughter of an alien whore. I'm going to try another Pokeball. If that doesn't work, I'm going to start trying to get Francois awake. One, two, three. There we go. So we have Jigglypuff.
Jiggly.
I'm going to keep it a buck 50. I don't think I've ever in my life used Jigglypuff and Wigglytuff. What you got for me, Mike?
Kirby.
No. I'm not going to lie. If it was a male Jigglypuff, I would have given it Pavarotti. Because it likes sinning, therefore...
I suppose so. I suppose so. On that same line.
Doesn't have to be an opera singer. Female. Let's see. I don't want to be too on the nose and choose an obvious one.
I mean, what's an obvious?
Obvious one that comes to my head is Adele, but.
What if we... I've got one. I know I'm not naming the Pokemon, though, so I can't. Mm. I do have one. I was thinking... I did have a female musician that came to mind first, which was Lizzie Hale of Hailstorm. But then I had a second one come to mind. That one I can't tell you, though.
That's fair. Let's just...
He's like, I will consult Google. But hey, we're 2 for 2, and no one's dead yet.
You know what? Let's call her Beyonce.
Oh, Beyonce. All the single ladies in this stream. Am I right?
Me!
Woo!
What's up?
Right, let's have a little look.
I was gonna Google saying, like, top female singers, and then... just popped up. I know who will be in this, and Beyonce was one of them. So,
special attack down, special defense up, cute charm, contact with the Pokemon may cause infatuation. I mean, to be fair, that combined with Sing is going to be really annoying. The fact that it's female is really good because a lot of the gym leaders and hard light fights in this game, they tend to be male Pokemon, and you can also cause infatuation with, you know, the opposite gender.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, you know, Pokemon,
I didn't know that was a thing in Pokemon.
It is. It is a thing in Pokemon. Yes, good sir.
Now that I've named this Pokemon, what was the name you were thinking?
I'm afraid I can't tell you that. I will tell you... Oh, we could have had a Numel. I know I've already got a fire type, but that would have been cool. Wait, does this thing know ground type moves? Run far away. I will tell you that name once we are past a certain point.
Okay.
So 2 for 2. We do need to level up these other plebs. We will worry about that once we've caught our next Pokemon, though. Also, I'll be collecting
my... Come to think of it, Pink would have worked just as well.
Pink would have been superb. It would have been very on the nose. But it would have been superb.
Can't you rename it?
Nah. You can rename it, but I mean, in a Nuzlocke, this, you know. Right, what could this Hoppip? I'm going to try waking up against this Hoppip. What could it do to me? What do you know? Synthesis. Okay. Not bad. Splash. Okay. Yep, yep, yep. Uh-huh. Yep, yep, yep. Lovely. We take those speed EVs. 42! Bro! Right, come on. Let's fight someone else. Pidgey. That'll also give me speed EVs. And a fast Francois is a happy Francois. I'm so close to having Ember. So close. In fact, I want it before I go to the Pokemon Center. I want it, I tells you. I need it. There's that rat I say you're after. Ember, 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 Ember. Yeah, there we go. Okay, right, we have Ember. We have our stab attack. Even though it's special attack, and our special attack is, how some may say, dog shit. At least we have it. All right. So what we're going to do is we are going to heal. We're going to go to Route 30, catch a Pokemon, and then we're going to start a small little training montage. That's the one thing with these increased difficulty hacks is you really have to kind of like get on top of your XP and leveling early. And I'm not going to make the same mistake I made in the test run where I damn near shit myself. Let's say Ellis told me to do a thing expecting... I was expecting one thing and very much another thing happened and I was the big scared.
Hey, slander.
Route 30. So as you've seen on Route 30, we could get Weedle, Kakuna, Caterpie, Metapod, Talo. Talo would be nice, but we already have Pidgey.
Rattata.
We've seen Seedot. What are we going to get? What are we going to get? What's it going to be?
Geodude.
I don't think I can get Geodude on this route. It's a Seedot. That is a grass type. Okay, so let's tackle. We certainly don't want to Ember, because we would kill it. Perfect. Hey, Kirsty, get thinking.
Oh, my. Oh. Oh.
What is it with these Pokemon breaking out my balls?
How many balls you got left?
Oh, like 10, maybe more. Yeah, 11. I'll be down to 10 after this one. I might go pick up some more. Bruh! What is your problem, sir? Bide should fail, because if I don't do any damage to it, it won't deal any damage back to me. There we are.
Yeah.
See, you were even given a few more moments to actually think about it. It is Seedot. It is the Acorn Pokemon. It's a boy. What you got?
Conker.
Conker.
Yeah, but with a K, not a C.
Oh, well, like, yeah, Conkers. Oh, no. Yeah, I know what you mean.
Am I doing just a K here as well?
Yeah.
No, make that one a C.
You going to make that one a C?
That would hurt me on every level.
And an A.
Oh, what? Just this, yeah?
Yeah.
Sure.
The most misspelled conquer in the world. Out to conquer the world.
Right, conquer, what have we got? The benefit, bold nature. Attack down, defense up. I'm getting just the best natures. Just the best natures. Just.
That's all right, you're getting tanky natures.
Yeah, but I need to deal some damage at some point. Fucking.
That sounded painful.
Right, anyway, we're going to start leveling up Harper a little bit.
Heck yeah.
We're going to have to do some switch training right now. We could have had Lotad.
Alas, you did not.
I did not. What are my odds on actually doing... I'm curious.
Curiosity killed the Pokemon.
You shut your mouth.
Just because I'm right.
See, use growl. And that lowers my attack. But I'm a special attacker. Well, with gust at least, so. One more. Astonish. Can't hit me. It's a ghost type move. See. Harper too OP. Harper too OP. Please ban Harper.
Or don't. At least ban him until after he faints. He faints.
I like the way you're wishing death to Harper already.
I'm not. I merely stated if. When and if.
It's a Caterpie. I'm pretty sure Harper can take this on as well. This thing can't hit me that strongly, right? Most of the Pokemon early game will pretty much be decimated by flying types. The only issue being is we need a physical flying move. I don't know, because I'm fairly confident Pidgey doesn't actually learn Peck. I want to say...
He learned
Gust.
Well, we've got Gust, but Gust is a special move, and I need a physical move.
I'm pretty sure it does learn Peck. Or maybe you have to teach it Peck.
I'm trying to think, because this is like an improved quality hack, I might get something like Pluck or Wing Attack early, but I don't know. God, look at the levels. Look at the mad stacks that Harper is getting. About to be level 5. About to join Beyonce. Okay. That does nothing against Gust, you see? This is all coming together. All coming together. Rude. Whoa! Good sir! I can't afford another critical hit. I will die. So as such...
Run away!
As such...
Well, swap out your Pokemon.
Beyonce. Sort it out. And it would have used Bullet Seed. I might have died to Bullet Seed. I would have died to Bullet Seed.
You definitely would have died to Bullet Seed. As long as Beyonce doesn't die to Bullet Seed.
Beyonce will not die to Bullet Seed. Oh no. I think we should be fine. Yeah, we're fine. We're fine. I had all the confidence in the world. No one looked back on stream to see the fear in my eyes.
Did I? I already did.
The fact that Bullet Seed could have potentially killed, like, think Bullet Seed hitting 5 times and getting a critical every time. How likely is that? Unlikely. However, it could happen.
And it probably has happened.
Oh, it 100% has happened to people before, yeah. So we're going to heal. So we got a Pokemon on Route 30. I know we've got Dark Cave. Dark Cave is a different route, yes. We could take it early, or we could save it for later in the game. But in all honesty, I'm more prepared to take it early, because later in the game, the encounters don't matter as much. We do also have a fishing spot at Cherry Grove, but I'm going to take that later for reasons I feel like I don't want to explain.
Okay.
Just cause.
Let me put it to you this way, Mike. I was like, it'll be a level 5 Magikarp. That's all I can catch with an old rod. So anyway, I'm leading with my level 10 fire type, and what pops out the ground but a level 10 water type that was not a Magikarp? Fecal matter. Exited. It was a Krabby, which learns water moves and ground moves, both of which are super effective against fire.
Good old Mr. Krabs making an appearance.
Dare I say, at first I was afraid. I was petrified.
Open this door.
Good sir, do you have anything to say?
Yes, I would like to say.
When you run, the noise will attract them, yeah. So even the kid is giving you the knowledge there. Okay, do I feel ready for my first Pokemon battle?
I don't know, do you?
Against a trainer. Do I feel ready for that? I think Barbell's got it, surely. Barbell's got it, right?
Yeah.
Because look, it's Youngster Joey. I look... Sir!
That was a bit rude.
That was very rude of Youngster Joey. With his top percentage level 7 Rattata.
Get it.
I'm going to try. Quick attack. How much damage is that going to do? Please don't do loads. It did 9. That is large. However, I did more than 9. Can't die to a crit, because a crit would be 18. And just like that, first Pokemon battle was in the books. Barbell absolutely crushed it, as opposed to me usually getting crushed by said Barbell. We'll give Joey our number.
Why are you giving your number to little children?
Canonically in this game, I am 10. Yeah, what do you think about that?
FBI, open up, bitch!
Are you a trainer? You are a trainer. Flower power? Have you got grass-type Pokemon? What the fuck?! 4
He's
Pokemon!
He's got all the Pokemon!
Bro!
She's not doing the Nuzlocke, she's not doing Nuzlocke.
Absorb, that's fine. I mean, this could be perfect for Francois or Harper, actually. So this is where the set battle mode is going to come in, because normally now we'd get the opportunity to switch. Mm-hmm. But we're not going to get that. Instead, she's just going to yeet a Pokemon out. Sentret. Oh, that's... That right there is not a grass type. So we're going to stay in. Because right now, Barbell deals the most damage. We're getting Stab on Tackle because of the typing. And we get the Adaptability boost. Tackle right now basically has 100 base power.
Heck yeah.
That crit didn't matter. Okay. C-Dot. Perfect. Perfect, 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 perfect. So, we are going to go into Harper. Because as well, not only are these C-Dots and these Pokemon higher level, you automatically get higher level off of trainer Pokemon as well. Bide, fantastic. Bide will only do damage if I damage it. So, take my sand, good sir.
Okay, I will be back soon.
Okay, bye.
I'm just going to pop off for a second.
She's popping off!
I suppose when we get to her turn, maybe we just sit around awkwardly waiting for her return.
Oh, Harper.
Or we could not do that. That's probably a better idea.
Look at this. All going according to plan. What's your next Pokemon? Go on. Go on. What you got for me? What you got for me? A Cherubi, eh? This Harper pickup could actually be, you know... As long as we carry Harper quite well, because... The second gym, should Harper remain alive that long, is a bug gym. Good. So, you know, flying does work well against bug.
Harper, VIP.
Very important Pokemon. I concur, sir. I concur. I just need to make sure we get that physical type flying move, or that physical damage flying move, rather. Harper getting those levels, though.
Come on, get the move.
Oh, bro.
You level up. Oh, so close to leveling up twice.
That's fine, because we, let's look at the XP. We know Barbell. Bruh. Uno XP is required.
Salty.
Right, Harper, up. You're going in. I know you're not a trainer, but just in case you are, perfect. This will get me a level up. Gust it. Probably won't be a one-hit KO, sadly. Or it will be. He'll just crit. Harper.
I told you, VIP, mate.
Alright. Well, Harper's got a decent amount of levels. Let's put Barbell back up front for the trainer battles, because I actually feel confident throwing Barbell out against the trainer. And again, I don't think you're a trainer. Right. I can't remember what level your Pokemon is. I am going to... I feel like a bit of a bitch running back to the Pokemon Center. So, I'm not going to do that. Even though I should, because it's a Nuzlocke. Okay. Who's ready to see how old this ROM hack is?
Go for it.
Hey, I just met you, and this is crazy, but let's have a battle. I'll win, maybe. Because this is Idol Carly. And that is the female singer name that popped into my head after Lizzie Hale. Like, yes. And obviously, she's got Jigglypuff, which is a Pokemon that sings. It, you know. Writes itself, this comedy, don't it?
It's a comedy of errors.
Skitty, eh?
Not the skitty.
Skitty is a kitty.
What does skitty evolve into again?
Delcatty.
Kitty.
How's it going, Super Mario? Super Mario 22 was taken. Didn't fancy Super Mario 23, no? Oh, man, what? I wasn't even paying attention. Oh, still nailed the tackle. Barbell, Giga Chad energy. Is my chat box not working, actually? I know it's working over here, but I don't think it's actually working on stream or on the overlay. All right, I'll look at that at some point. At some point. And a Clefairy. Do we stick in with Barbell? Barbell's already level 10. I don't really want Barbell to run away with it. Could send in Francois. Francois could do with the additional experience. Although then in Francois is probably going to see a lot of use in Sprout Tower. But then again, so will Harper. How much damage are you taking from that pound? 4 damage. Really nothing to worry about. Okay, 3 shots. Kill it with Ember. Easy. If I wasn't faster, you know, if I wasn't faster, I'd have been terrified. Could have died to a crit. Would have been very unnecessary. Okay. Idol Carly has been bested, and she lost so bad. Right. Let's use a potion on Francois. I think Barbell is okay for now. And let's put Beyonce up front. Oh, single ladies. Oh, single ladies.
Put your hands up, sing it.
So we got... So that was Route 30. Is this Route 31? This is Route 31. So we have 2 Pokemon. We've got Route 31 up here. And then we've got Dark Cave just over here as well. Got a potion back. Okay. Route 31 encounter. Is backseating allowed? Depends to what degree. I'd like to keep this game as relatively blind as possible. Like I say, I know it somewhat because, you know, Gen 2 is my favorite, but I don't know too much about what Draiano has done with the quality of life stuff. But, like, feel free to let me know about, like, items and stuff. That I'm fine with, but... Yeah. What are we going to get for Route 31? I am not mad about that. Psychic is a good type. So, like, I can't say stuff like X area has Y encounters, but I can say stuff... Y is a great encounter. I'd be totally fine with that. Totally fine with that. Don't want to be critically hit by this thing. Yeah, I want it to be spoiled. Sorry, I don't want my potential encounters to be to be spoiled. We got the Johto! Nice. I'm actually not upset by that. Another flying type. Psyking is... Psyking? Psykick is great to have early on. Give a nickname? Absolutely. Ellis, you're up.
Am I up? Oh, God.
And it's a female.
Oh, oh no. Not another bird name.
Get out of your...
Yeah, you've, this is the second burb that you've named.
Harpy.
For fuck's sake. Yeah. Crates are times two in this. I think, thankfully, I was taking seven damage to air cutter and I had 15. So if it was double, is burb taken? Burb and the name has not been taken.
We like burb. Put we burb go... in.
Fuck's sake. That's the least imagination's been used so far. Fucking burb. All right.
Don't worry. The next one.
The next one. Let's have a look at Burb's nature, shall we? Mild nature. Special attack up! Let's go! We actually got a good one.
Finally, a good one.
With air cutter and confusion. That's not dreadful, you know? Okay, so we now have Dark Cave coming up. Dark Cave could also potentially... Just because I know, like I say, I know this Pokemon game quite well. Tried to get into the Gen 4 Battle Frontier. What game was the Battle Frontier in Gen 4? Was it in the Heart Gold Soul Silver? Like, I never really remember the post game too much. The Psytrom, I did Kanto and then Mount Silver, right? Okay, it was him. I don't think I dabbled with that too much. I know Dark Cave could have a Geodude. I'm kind of hoping for a Geodude because that will really help against Faulkner. It was in Platinum as well. Yeah, you're right. It was in Platinum. I did play a lot of Platinum as well. Okay. Dark Cave. Come on, Geodude. Or just Rock type. I don't want to specifically say Geodude. Some of the trainers have max EVs and IVs. God damn. Okay, that's not exactly what I wanted. That is a bust. But we will catch it because you never know if it will be useful or not. All right. Nice, we got it. I'm Alex Zam with bad AVs and a speed lower in nature, you think? So a Staraptor outsped and one shot it. Oh, God, yeah. And against the Staraptor as well, that thing's going to absolutely brutalize your Alakazam. It's got the physical defense of wet tissue. Right, we need to give a name to the Chingling. Mike, you're up.
What is this thing?
It's a great question. It's a great question. If it helps you, not saying it will ever evolve. Less than that, defense of wet paper. True. It evolves into a Pokemon called Chimecho, if that helps you, if you want to take a look at that, which does is essentially, now that I think about it, Chimecho. It's like a wind chime. Looks like a wind chime.
So something with wings, maybe.
Female, by the way.
Yes. We're not naming it Flatulence.
I mean, I can't influence. I had a name for it. See, I've taken out the whole thing of name your Pokemon to form an emotional bond with them because I get my friends to name my Pokemon for me.
Jokes on you. I don't give a shit about your Pokemon.
That's true. That's true.
Harkens over to some Welsh language, which wins is meaning Gwen. Let me just double check on that.
You go ahead. You go ahead, sir.
I remember looking up something like that when I wanted to name characters for a... It was a game design document for myself, but nothing came out of it, of course.
Oh, I never did. Hold on. I'll just remember. While you're doing that, I'm going to quickly do something.
Aha. Hear it. I got it.
All right, hold up. Give me 2 seconds.
1, 2. I have it.
Sir, you need...
Wait, you said 2 seconds.
You need to calm one's tartars.
Fine. I'll soothe my boobs.
Excellent. All right, I'm here. Back in the room.
Are you sure?
Yep.
Okay. Gwint.
Gwint.
Which is how I should spell it. G for golf.
Yep.
W for whiskey. Y for Yankee. N for November. And T for tango.
I did think it might be a Y because you did say it was Welsh. Okay, that's unfortunate because I was banking on a rock type.
Out of interest, what would you have named it?
Well, it was a female, and you said something to do with when, something to do with wind. So my brain immediately went, we call it Queef.
Disgraceful.
God damn it.
Queef McKenzie, am I right, boys?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm dead inside.
Dude, you and me both. Okay, we do have a bug catcher coming up. We could send Harper in against it to get some good experience, and then we are going to need to grind Beyonce and Conker. I am going to use a potion on Burb, just because Burb is level 7 and could be useful in combat. I don't know how much we're going to actually progress through this for the rest of the stream. Don't get me wrong, we've still got a little bit of time, but I would like to do grinding, actually have a full team ready. And we might do Sprout Tower. I doubt we'll do the gym today. Are you a trainer, sir? I forget. No, you're not. All right. Well, we'll take the Apricorn. Lovely, so lovely. Gimme, gimme. Black Apricorn. And then there is a trainer just down here. But there is an item here. Splendid. Well, we'll take that Pokeball. Good day, sir. You there, boy. What year is this? Bow, 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 bow. 4 Pokemon, eh? Spinarak. Two-shot? Okay. We'll take a 2-shot. Bug Bite is just an insanely powerful move. Like, in terms of base power. And if I had given berries, they would munch on them, and that would make me really sad. Man, why couldn't we got the crit the first time? That'd have made me happy. Level up. Let's go, Harper. We got Pluck! We got that physical move! Leddy Bar. Yeah, let's Pluck. Go on. Get that experience. Will it one hit? Oh, yes! We have unlocked Harper's ascended form. Surskit. I am going to switch against the Surskit. I'm going to go into Burb. Let's see if Burb can do well in combat. I know it's not a clean switch. And this thing is going to hit me. Not for dreadful damage, thankfully, though. Right, Air Cutter. Let's go. Quick attack. That one. Do 3. Damn and Blast. We'll go for the guaranteed hit with Confusion. Seeing as Air Card does have a 5% chance to miss. Ooh, Nincada, Bug Ground. Very fascinating type. Dragon Dancing Salamence. Dude! Dragon Dance Salamence is busted. Or just a, like, if you couldn't get one with Dragon Dance, like, imagine a high speed one with Moxie. I know that that's not a thing in Gen 4, but still. And third is the flex. I mean, the Dragon Dance Salamence sounded like a flex. Alright. Do we have any more trainers that we need to fight? Or are we Gucci? could we get to a... By flex, you mean you don't know that. Ah, with ya. Understood. I'm picking up what you're putting down. Is this guy a trainer? I don't know. You're not a trainer. Okay. All right. Well, we have made it to Violet City. Thankfully, we don't have to battle Lyra. I need to tell you, your team gets wrecked by Titar. Yeah, your Alakazam has kind of not got any defense whatsoever. And Rock would absolutely murder Salamence. Alright, Violet City. About time we got one of those Shardyberry. Trade a berry for a shard. Okay. What should I do to round out the team? I mean, my brain immediately goes to something physically defensive, just because realistically you don't have much in terms of physical defense. Okay, so we now get the opportunity for a Pokemon. Also, HP fighting. HP fighting is good. HP fighting is very good. So we're going to drop off... Oh, hey, here's Gwint with Levitate. Okay, so that means ground-type moves would never hit it. And it has a docile nature. That is completely neutral. Yeah, okay, that's... Nothing. Dark coverage. Yeah, I mean, the problem is Focus Blast has... Is it a 30% chance to miss? I suppose you have got HP fighting, which is going to be better, though. Would you perhaps want, like, I don't know, a sturdy fighting type? I'm trying to think of what might be able to actually fill that role, though. I was going to deposit a Pokemon, and I completely forgot to. So here's one thing I do know about the game. And I learned this because of... I was... So Conker... No one told Kirsty. Conker died. Okay? Conker died. He's gone to Brazil. But we're going to get another Pokemon. We just need to chat to this guy. And if we pass a quiz, we get a Pokemon. I would love to take a quiz, sir. Were any Hoenn Pokemon obtainable within Fire Red and Leaf Green? Yes, they were. Time for question 2. Is Dragon Dare more than 13 feet long? Yes, it is. Semi-final question. Is it true that Bulbasaur was the first Pokemon created? No, it wasn't. And the final question. Can Tropius be found within Diamond and Pearl? Yes. Oh, it can't. Fuck, I forgot. I thought we could. Be real embarrassing if I got any more of these wrong, right? Oh, it's Platinum it can be found in. It can be found in Gen 4. It's Platinum that you can be found in. Okay, so we now get to choose between Bulbasaur, Charmander, and Squirtle as our prize Pokemon, our gift Pokemon, if you will.
Oh, I see.
And you might Squirtle. Be thinking, Simon, the obvious choice. You've got a grass Pokemon. You've already got a grass Pokemon. So take Bulbasaur, so you can't take Bulbasaur. You've already got a fire type Pokemon. You can't take Charmander.
It's about fat Charmander is the best choice, regardless.
So, I should take Squirtle, right?
In theory.
That's the logic here, right?
Mm-hmm. Logically, yes.
We're taking Charmander.
Yeah, thank fuck for that, because I'm going to say, we're team incompetent. We don't believe in logic.
And I will tell you why we're taking Charmander.
He's a sexy boy.
It would be Kirsty's name in here, but sadly she is gone, so it rolls over to Ellis.
Oh,
apparently,
God.
Ellis is not a bird type.
Yeah, it's not a bird. I mean, it does eventually learn to fly, so long as I don't kill it.
Oh, what was the name of that... Fat Dragon from the Dungeons & Dragons movie, Ellis.
It's a good question.
Actually, none come to think of it, I don't think it would fit. It was a long name.
I will explain my reasoning for Charmander once I have a name.
Name him Salamander, if you can.
Will that fit?
With a set?
Oh!
Salaman.
Yeah, that fit.
And just D-E-R, yeah?
Yeah.
No, Salah, no. There's an N
missing
there.
Oh, you forgot the N.
Salamander.
N-D-E-R.
Yeah. I was looking at it and I was like, I am missing something here, definitely. Salamander.
Definitely.
So, I have a reason. Now, don't get me wrong. Venusaur is wonderful for Nuzlocke. Perfectly bulky, Leech Seed, Giga Drain, all that good stuff. Synthesis.
To be a Venusaur.
Squirtle is sadly just pure water. There are better water type Pokemon available. However, Charmander, it's only level 10 right now, and it's a jolly nature, which is special attack down. I'm just having the best time, but it is speed up, and within theory, you can do physical Charizard, right? Obviously, I don't think I can get it egg moves because you can have Dragon Dance Charizard. The good news, however, is this Charmander, in a few levels, will learn the move Dragon Rage. Dragon Rage always does 40 HP of damage, making the early game incredibly easy. So you thought I was a madman. Alright, anyway, I have some training to go do. Before I do that, I'm going to go urinate. So, gentlemen, if you wouldn't mind entertaining the chat, I'd appreciate it. Feel free to talk amongst yourselves. Che, you got this.
Okay. I'm assuming he's got the headset on still so he can hear us. In which case, I have funny haha story.
Go for the funny haha.
Yes, so my mum picked me up to go to lunch today. So I got in the car. I immediately could smell something a bit off. So a bit of banter between us two. She said it was my coat, which it wasn't. I said it was possibly her BO, because she said she'd come from the gym, which apparently it wasn't. She was quite adamant that she had a shower and everything, so it clearly wasn't that. So, played on our minds for a while. Driving back, I made a suggestion. Could it be anything damp in your car? I said, well, the only damp thing I can think of I have in the car right now is the wet towels from my aqua aerobics. Okay. So, and then she said, oh yeah, and my smelly, my sweaty sock.
Oh, no! Yeah,
that'll fucking do it, won't it? Smelly, sweaty socks! She did nearly crash after from laughing too much, but...
Potent.
Yeah, as soon as she said socks, the smell became worse as my brain registered what it was.
Oh, God.
It was like, oh, and thankfully, she was just coming back to my road, so I was able to get out of there quick.
Did you get the old forceps out and throw the sock out the window?
I didn't even know where the socks were, but either way, I got out of the car very quick.
And here I was thinking it was going to be a story about your mother taking up smoking the devil's lettuce.
No.
Whoa.
I was going to say, I've mapped the buttons wrong. I thought I've been pressing X, but I've actually... I am a fool.
Yeah, okay. Especially for choosing a Charmander.
See, you had a perfect opportunity. You could have called it Squirtle. That, good sir, is on you for not taking the opportunity.
I mean, Salamander's a good name.
Salamander's a great name, but you could have just been like, you should be Squirtle. Anyway, the grinding shall commence. Hey, it's a Bellsprout. Go, Burb. Good news is, we can hit this thing super effectively with both Confusion and Air Cut. It does give attacky these. Could you name a mon that can deal with Weavile, Bronzong, and Titar? I mean, the Weavile and the Titar get absolutely bodied by fighting. The Bronzong really depends, because Bronzong could either have Heat Proof, which deals with its fire weakness, or it could have Levitate, which deals with its ground weakness. Weavile outspeed, yeah, that's true. Weavile does outspeed. I mean, Weavile's really frail, like Alakazam as well. Anything with Muck Punch. Is that a potential option? I was going to say Breloom, but obviously Breloom would die to any kind of like ice damage. But... Sizzle? Technician Bullet Punch? Because the Bullet Punch will also work on the T-Tar as well. But the Bronzong... Yeah, man, the Bronzong is a... The Bronzong's a bit of an issue there, because like I say, Heat Proof deals with fire. Got anything that could hit it with Dark? Steel does resist... Steel resists Dark in that generation, so it's still hitting neutrally. Could do Ghost, but not Dark. Zama Shadow Ball. That could work. Realistically, it shouldn't have anything else that could hit you, right? Good job, Burb. Good job. Fucking Burb. The thing is, I said Burb when we had the Pidgey as well. Here's what you could have had earlier. Staraptor with a speed boost in nature outspeeds them. Bye.
If you caught that, I would have called it a Tinder profile. You match with them and they ghost you.
I mean, this is for true.
Admittedly, that wouldn't have fit in. It could be like Tinder.
No, we could have just called it Tinder.
Yeah, that's true.
Your current Zam would trash BDBs. The solution here sounds like get a better Alakazam. Okay, you're already working on a better Alakazam. All right, well, that answers that then, doesn't it? Burb, teleport. Do you know what? I'm actually going to take that on the grounds of... What if I'm in a cave and it's looking real bad and I can just teleport back to a Pokemon Center?
That's not a bad shout.
Listen, I'm taking this very for seriously. I'm not, as one might say, jimmying around.
So you mock Burb, but Burb's going to be your most OP...
I'm not mocking Burb. Get it. Funny, ha-ha. Burb has got a fantastic nature. And I am down for Zartu. I have no issue with the Zartu. Let me see if Psychic Oko's... I mean, what? Psychic is 90 base... Plus the stab is what? 135. Staraptor is not exactly specially bulky, is it? Okay, that's a two shot. I'm down for that. We'll get Burb to level 10 and then we'll have to start training the Beyonce and... Oh no, Harper's level... Harper's level 9, that's when he got plucked. Yeah.
I thought Harper went up to 10.
I think it's only 9. Might be 10. You might be right. If you're paying more attention to this than me, I'm disappointed in myself. Dude, I'm getting real hungry. I cannot wait to chow down on one of those Jamaican patties, let me tell you. Let me tell you something, brother.
Let me tell you something.
And I know we've got the entirety of Sprout Tower that we could do. But we'll see where we get. We'll do some mild grinding. Man, I want it. I want it. Oh,
it's
yes.
It's never going to happen, isn't it?
When I was explaining the rules as well, I completely forgot about dupe's claws.
Yep.
So yeah, a dupe's claws is that if I've already caught a Pokemon and that's the first encounter on the route, then I get to reroll. That's been bugging me. I was sitting there like earlier and I was like, I feel like I forgot to mention summon as part of the rules. So I am playing with dupe's claws. Sometimes it can be funny not playing with dupe's claws, especially like fire red, and you just end up with a team of like three Rattatas. I mean, technically you could, like, some people do that. And to be fair, Raticate's not dreadful, you know? Man, I really want the special attack EVs, but I know I can't one-hit kill it. I mean, we're now faster than it. Crit, though. Burb just listens. Burb!
Oh. Burb is the OG.
Burb's just a Chad, you know? Yeah, Harper is level 9. So we'll switch Harper. We'll get Harper to 10, then we'll start training Beyonce. Guaranteed 2-hit KO without a crit. Yeah, true. True, true. So close to being a range, man.
Just the way you scream that out.
97.5%, dude. That is so rough.
Sorry.
And have you got perfect special attack IVs as well?
Sorry.
For fuck's sake. I'm not even going to say what came to mind just then. I'm not even going there. You know exactly what I'm thinking as well.
Sorry. All right, that's enough. What's up now?
Let's put Beyonce and all the single ladies up front. What level is Sprout Tower? Surely we're fine, right? Even if you had perfect, which you don't, it'd still be an 8.3% chance to Oko. Man, I'd take that coin flip. I know you don't have that coin flip currently, but I would take the 8.3% coin flip chance. Yeah, listen, coin flip. 10% of the time, 50% of the time. And if it's 50% of the time, it works every time. And you can tell by that logic that I'm going to lose this Nuzlocke.
Yeah, your little type.
Right, I was going to train Beyonce. Hey, Beyonce, how you doing? Rolling around in the grass? She's having a great time. I feel like I want to grind Beyonce in Sprout Tower, but that could end badly-ish. Let's hit up the mart, actually, and collect some supplies. And explore the city, actually. Chat to NPCs, get things, because who knows what I could end up getting. This is a Drayano hack at the end of the day. He does like to put some quality of life in there. Thank you very much. Yep. It was about 3 years ago, this group of thugs called Team Rocket was involved in wrongdoing. They were abusing Pokemon, but bad things never last. A boy did a wonderful job, and Team Rocket was disbanded. Yes, boy. What should you do for Weavile, Tivar, and Bronzong, though? I don't know, dude. Fighting resolves so much of that, but the Bronzong is really what's messing with me. The only thing, like, do you know what ability the Bronzong is going to have? Like, do you know if it's... No. Bruh! I'm glad I was talking to people. Well, this solves my problem immediately. Okay. I would take the coin flip, and this one is actually a coin flip, on it being Levitate, and therefore I would grab a fire fighting Pokemon. If it has Levitate, you do that without Levitate, right? It's cool. I thought that's what you meant. If it has Levitate, you don't Earthquake. And then let's put Salamander up front, I think. Because here's the thing, right? I would... If it does, you get a bulky fire type. Yeah. Yeah, bulky fire type. I would say, I mean, realistically, you could probably get a fire fighting type that can learn EQ. Infernape comes to mind, but Infernape isn't bulky. That's the only thing. I'm a solid roughneck, and I'm a ruffian. T-Star still wrecks you. I mean, T-Star's not that fast. Within theory, Infernape would be faster, and if it had a close combat, or I don't know, Blaziken. Speed boost Blaziken, but it would have to survive a turn. Alakazam has Focus Blast. And you're better, obviously, hitting it specially than physically. Good sir! Do I have a Rhyhorn? Want to trade one for your Gligar? You know, I'd love to, but I don't have a Rhyhorn. Oh, hello. Pokemon School? Excellent. Salamander slowly wandering around. Come on, Salamander, pay attention. Oh, Rock Smash. What is back there? I bet there's an item back there, and I want it. Yeah, the thing that comes to mind, I mean, I'll be honest, I play my Pokemon, like, fast and loose. Giggity. My mind immediately says Infernape, because Infernape will be able to hit it with a Fire-type move. If it, a fire type will just be super effective because it's steel. Of course, it is weak against psychic. So, that's obviously, you know, the inverse that you have there. Ghost could be a good shout, but then you don't want it to be ghost poison. So, your best bet could be, I don't know, Sableye is not the best in Gen 4. When you got his holding something. Hells yeah. Oh, wait, no. Did I chat to the dude with the book? I don't know. My brain literally just... I'm not going to read the blackboard, CB8. Right, there's the gym, which we're not going to challenge until we've done Sprout Tower. Bonjour. You are a trainer, battle gym leader, when you did? Yes! Yes, I did! I think he bought it, chat. I think he thinks I beat Faulkner.
Well, he's currently standing very confused by a river and a tree and a small little garden. So, I think he's not all... I think he's a few sandwiches short of picnic.
No, he... That guy, I believe in that guy. I'll take 4 potions. We will grab... Nope. We'll grab another couple Pokeballs as well. Just 4. Take me to a nice lucky 12. Keep some money in reserve. Good day, boy. I think I have the opportunity to catch another Pokemon, actually. You called your Pidgey Strawberry. So she did. What route is this? Is this a route? This is Route 36. Odd tree is blocking the way to Ecstatic City. It's preventing me from shopping. Okay, fair play. No, there's no grass here. Okay. I think there might be grass that I can reach, but I'm not going to I'm not going to worry about it too much right now. All right, Sprout Tower. What could possibly go wrong here? Child, you are too young.
Child, did you take him a battle out of my way, small
now,
boy?
Yeah.
Backhands him across the bridge.
Over 100 feet tall and breathe fire. I hate the fact that this...
If you look, I hate the fact that it moves.
Well, it's moving because people are training upstairs. Like, that's their, like, in that's like, canon thing, reason. But Jesus Christ, like, if that doesn't fill you with anxiety...
Yeah, I know. It's like, one of the main support pillars apparently moves because people are being too vigorous upstairs.
Oh, wait, can we catch wild Pokemon? We get wild Pokemon in here. I completely forgot about Sprout Tower encounters.
Okay, maybe not exactly pillar, but you get the message. It's just like asking for a disaster pattern.
Oh no.
Level 12.
Yeah, ooh. Oh no.
I think you're a bit too premature being here. 9 damage. Oh, God.
Sometimes you just gotta hope.
Oh, no.
Big yikes. Okay, it can't hit Harper super effectively. It can't hit it with Astonish. It could only hit me with Gust. So let's send out Harper. Let's try and get some more damage on this thing. Astonish, that's fine. That doesn't hit me. Let's go for Pluck. Gust, that's fine. 12. That did, like, nothing. Okay, I'm going to try. One. Oh, you. This thing could be really annoying. I want it. I want it so bad. Oh, I'm playing risky right now. I want it, 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 I want it. Get in the ball, Drifloon!
No.
Get in the ball, Drifloon. Constrict. That shouldn't do... Okay, that's fine.
Barbell just tanking the hit there.
Bite is super effective. Will it kill? I don't think it will. Don't kill, don't kill, don't kill, don't kill, don't kill, don't kill. Yes! Okay, I want it. I want it so bad. I want it so bad.
Drifloon is tanking everything.
Drifloon has got... Sure, okay. Drifloon and its evolution have insanely high HP. Thankfully, I don't have to worry about damaging it anymore.
Now you just need to make sure you don't run out of Pokeballs.
Yeah. I did buy 4 more.
Let's go!
Drifloon! Yeah. And since Kirsty's still not back, Mike, it is up to you. Now, Mike, before you come up with a name...
Looks like a heartless.
Before you come up with a name based upon it, I'm going to read you Drifloon's Pokedex entry.
Is this the one that carries small children off into the atmosphere?
It is! It is whispered that any child who mistakes Drifloon for a balloon and holds onto it, could wind up missing.
Very well, its name shall be Little Shit.
Is that going to fit?
But without the space, I think so.
Eventually, it becomes a big shit.
That's the only time we can appropriately change its name. It will fit.
It will fit. I want to go to upper. There we go. Perfect. Right. We have obtained...
A little shit.
Yes. We have obtained Little Shit. And now, we are going...
As you can tell, I normally put some very thoughtful names to my Pokemon, but there's every now and again, no thought will go into whatsoever.
I mean, I'm curious. I'm curious.
First thing that comes to mind.
I want to see if that was like just an exceptionally higher leveled one, or if... No, that is just the level around here. Jesus Christ. Because I know in the base game, at night time, which we're in now, because it's after 8 p.m, it could be ghastly.
Ghastly?
I want to see how much XP I get for killing one. Oh no, my speed. Anyway. It's a 3-hit KO. I think as well I'm going to go and train. I think I'm going to go and do that grinding. And I'm glad... Yeah. Oh, Aftermath! I forgot about Aftermath. Does mine have Aftermath? Also, Beyonce, I'm sorry, but you're about to become the single lady. And the single lady is in the box. I was wondering if that Drifloon might have been like a rare encounter, but no. I think it's just the ghost type and it's night, so. Boom, boom, ba down, boom. Ban and now. Okay. Thank you. Right. So we are going to take the XP share off of Beyonce. Yep. We're going to move our Pokemon. Oh, it has... And it's got a lonely nature. Oh! Drifloon with the lonely nature, which increases attack, decreases defense. God damn. And it's got Aftermath, so damages the foe at landing the final hit. So if I do need to sacrifice it, it can at least do damage with Constrict, Minimize, Astonish, and Gust. Astonish has been buffed in this game as well. Nice. Okay. Well, Little Shit, you may now join the team.
Yay!
Sorry, Beyonce. I said about not using a Wigglytuff, and that trend is going to continue.
You never know, you might come back to it.
I might. I might have a reason to do it. Now, what I need to do between streams, because I prepared this very rapidly before actually going live, I need to gen rare candies into the game so I don't just have to EXP grind, just because it will make my life a lot easier, because once I get a Pokemon, I can just like rare candy it up. It'll lose out on the EVs, but at least I'll actually get a level. Saves me having to do what I'm going to have to do now, which is basically, you know, grind. But sometimes it do be like that. I don't think I'm going to put the XP share on any Pokemon. I think I'm just going to go and grind away for a little bit. I'll do that on stream just for now. And then, you know, I'll do a bit more off stream just so for whenever we're next live, because who knows when it'll be. We're not under level for anything. So, and of course, to be kept up to date with when we go live, we could have had Shinx. To be kept up to date when we go live, please consider dropping a follow or joining. Right, Simon, process the thought in one go before you start rambling. Consider hitting the follow button down below That will send you notifications when we go live. And if you have enjoyed the content, then consider joining our Discord server. Link should be in the description down below if you're viewing on YouTube. And it should also be wherever it happens to be on the Twitch profile. I only fairly recently switched back over to Twitch, so I don't fully know the UI as a as where it could be. I know it's fairly customizable, but it should be down there somewhere. If you want to join the Discord, you also get notifications of going live, and we occasionally chat in there as well. Because stuff.
And
there we go. I finished the thought process. Barbell just going to ram its whole body into a Pokemon again. How much is that going to do? 4. Pitiful.
Nom.
A very unnecessary crit. The one benefit that doing training out here does do, battling wild Pokemon, is we are going to get EVs. The EVs are going to be kind of focused on the areas of the Pokemon that we're fighting. So, you know, Bellsprout, Shinx, give us special attack. Give us physical attack. Buizel gives speed. Buizel being a really cool Pokemon that we could have had. That's a water type I would have used over Squirtle. Because it gets Aqua Jet, which is just water quick attack. Priority moves are very important in Nuzlocke.
Yes, yes, and yes.
Yes, 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 indeed. Oh, yes, Governor. Yes, absolutely. Bum, 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 bum. And you see, this Bellsprout's got a little bit more defense than the previous one. So yeah, ideally, if possible, and as much as it... Not pains me is the wrong word. I would actually like this Eevee to become an Umbreon. Even though Espeon is my favourite evolution, Dark type, physically defensive Dark type, with the ability to have a moveset of Toxic, Protect, Moonlight, and insert fourth move here, sounds like it's going to be an absolutely cancerous setup.
Oh dear.
And that's something I'm carrying from college days. There was a guy, I can't remember his name, but there was a guy that used to come into us when we were doing Pokemon battles in college. I don't know if you remember him, Ellis. But he had an Umbreon with Toxic, Protect, Moonlight, and I don't know what else it was. And that thing was a defensive wall. And I murdered it. Now... Did I lose the battle? Yes, but I was very happy I took out his ridiculous Umbreon. Hells yeah. So, but yeah, like, Umbreon can just sit there and, you know, do tick damage with Toxic and not get hit through Protect and heal up through Moonlight. Great.
I do remember you crowning about beating this Umbreon.
Well, because no one else had beat the Umbreon.
Yeah, I remember you saying this a lot.
I did, because no one else beat it. I did.
But I don't remember who said it was.
I forget. I couldn't remember. I cannot remember for the life of me who it was.
It wasn't Jody's partner at the time, was it?
No.
No. I know he had one, but it was obviously it wasn't that one then. To be fair, a lot of them had Umbreons.
Umbreon's good Pokemon.
Mm. So it doesn't really narrow it down.
No. I remember taking it out with my Houndoom. Houndoom triple nasty plot overheat. That did enough damage to take it out.
Houndoom, or as you said at the time, Houndoom! I had to endure him going at Houndoom for a bloody week.
Listen, you've had to endure me a lot over these years, alright?
And I wouldn't trade it for the world.
Aww, I need a sweetheart.
I can be sweet sometimes. Right, that's my sweet quota done for the week.
It's only Monday.
It makes you feel uncomfortable when you're sweet. Go back to being salty.
it makes me feel all warm and icky. I don't like it.
Yell at me now.
You're all utter bastards.
There we go. There's Grandad.
Times in the universe almost shifted then. Tectonic plates were moving.
Are you sure that wasn't just you in the toilet?
Oh. Not me, good sir. Would I do such a thing like that?
At least his anus go burr. Alright, well, Salamander's now getting some attention. Hopefully we can get him Dragon Rage sooner rather than later. I think that's 14 he learns it.
Where's Flamethrower?
Say yes.
A long way in the way. A long way away, sir. Hey, Shinx, how are we?
Flamethrower.
To think, we got Jigglypuff on this route. No, we didn't. That's a lie. We got Burb! Which, in all honesty, I haven't actually seen another Burb. Then again, it has gone to night time, so that, you know, the Pokemon does change at night. So. Ha! Take that, Shinx. Alright, we'll grind for just a few more battles and then we'll call it a stream, because I need to eat. I'm a hungry lad. But hey, Pokemon have been caught. No one died. And we still got Cherry Grove City that we could go back to. The fact we didn't kill that in one Ember makes me sick. Come on, Salamander. We get the crit now. He clearly heard me shit talking him. I know this isn't going to be the most engaging content, but trust me, when we come back and we're able to shit all over Sprout's hair and the gym next time, you'll be thankful that I do this shit. And I'm not just going to do it, like, on stream. Believe me, after I eat, I'm back on. I'm doing the grind. This is why I need those rare candies, because otherwise I'm going to go insane.
Rather you than me. I haven't got the patience.
I do when it comes to Pokemon. And this is just grinding randomly. I have, in my time, bred Pokemon for perfect IVs and then perfectly EV trained them. Good God, my Pokemon Y has some absurd time in it just by me. So I wanted to be efficient with the EV training, right? Because you earn EVs whenever you battle a Pokemon, depending on its EV distribution. This Shinx will give me one attack EV as an example. I didn't want to have to kill... And you can get 252 EVs in a single stat.
Okay.
I didn't want to have to kill the Pokemon 250-something times. That, good sir. Fuck that. So what I did was... in Pokemon Y, they introduced something called... Or X and Y. Horde encounters, where you could fight up to 5 Pokemon at once.
Yep.
And what you could do is in certain areas of the game, if you used the move Sweet Scent outside of battle, it would start a horde encounter. So you would fight these 5 Pokemon. But you're like, Simon, that's only 5. Holy shit, wild Butterfly!
Burn it with fire.
But you're like, Simon, you know, that's only 5. Yes, but what if my Pokemon got Pokerus, which means they get EVs twice as fast? Which means that's 10. And what if I made the Pokemon doing the murdering brilliant, burns it, and then kills it with fire? What if I made the Pokemon doing the killing hold the Macho Brace, which quadruples the EVs that it gets it? Then what I'm doing is I'm killing a horde of Pokemon, and I'm getting 40 EVs. Simon was in the sauce.
This Pokemon World Hat is a perfectly balanced game with no broken exploits whatsoever.
Well, I, you know, that's when I was into my competitive battling. That's when, you know, I'd actually, you know, try. Fucking hell, imagine trying now. Metal Claw. Yes. Giga Chad, yes. Give me Metal Claw. We don't need Scratch. We need Metal Claw. All right. Salamander has charged ahead in terms of levels. I think what I'm going to do there is I'm going to call it a stream. I am the big hungry. And I would like to consume the food before I come the big hangry. Let's just check in on Francois. Hey, Francois, how you doing?
Hey, it's a me.
Hey, he seems to want to play with me. Huh? Well, I'm pissing off. See you later, Francois.
What? What about cheese you promised me?
It's a good you can giz my ass, boy.
Monsieur!
But there we go. This has been part one of the Pokemon Storm Silver Nuzlocke. I hope you've enjoyed. Like I mentioned before, if you're live on Twitch here, drop a follow and join the Discord down below. And if you're viewing this as a VOD on YouTube, then consider following on Twitch. Description will be link will be in the description down below. And of course, like, subscribe, turn that or ding that notification bell to get notifications on when we do our uploads. And check out the description so you can join the Discord to get those same notifications as well. Push the Discord marketing. Yes, yes. Lovely, lovely. Gentlemen, how are we feeling about this venture back into Pokemon? It's been a while. I did a Pokemon Black 2 Nuzlocke last year.
It's been nostalgic.
It's been good. I haven't had the best of pulls with some of the Pokemon, but there's still many to come, so hopefully it all changes.
Natures haven't been great. Some have been really good. I'm happy with... If we consider where the early game is, so Faulkner is first with his flying types.
Simon no words today.
Simon no word. Me no likey to speak. With his flying types, so you know we're gonna have a bit of difficulty there. However, the second gym leader is Bugsy, who has bug type Pokemon, and currently we have 2 fire types and 3 flying types. So I think we'll be okay there.
I hope so.
And there is Union Cave that we can go to, which gives us another opportunity to get a rock type Pokemon. And I would enjoy a rock type Pokemon because rocks make bugs go squish.
Yep.
But
out comes the Zubat.
Do you know, I wouldn't hate a Zubat. First and foremost, that's another flying type. And second of all, Crobat is busted. I love Crobat so, so very much. But with that in mind, we must bid you adieu. Thanks so much for watching. Stay safe, stay happy, and we'll catch you next time.
Bye. Bye.